Now, before the break, we were speaking with Anne-Marie Cockburn from London, whose 15-year-old daughter, Martha, took ecstasy and died. Now, this mother actually wants ecstasy and other party drugs to be legalised, and she joins us again. Anne-Marie, thank you again. We're glad you can hear us now. Talk to us a little bit about Martha. Was she aware of the dangers surrounding drugs?
I think the school had tried to do what they could in order to educate. But I think a modern teenager is pretty desensitised to the dangers because they see it on TV, they see it in their communities. I think they're quite desensitised, actually. I did what I could to educate her myself, but I felt very naive.
Well, you're definitely not naive now, Anne-Marie. You know, you're calling for ecstasy to be legalised. Tell us a little bit about Martha. We saw some pictures of her before. She has had the most beautiful eyes.
Yes. She had those... They were very mesmerising. I would stare at her and she would say, "Are you admiring your work?" You know. But they were quite extraordinary, actually.
And Anne-Marie, how would you
envisage... Martha was just an ordinary teenager.
How would you envisage a legalisation scheme to work? At what sort of age would you like to see it kick in? How would it be distributed or administered?
Well, it would be 18 and above. It would be dealt with by pharmacists and doctors. It would all be licensed like normal pharmaceuticals are.
What sort of reaction have you had to your calls for the legalisation of ecstasy?
I've had a surprising amount of support. Behind the scenes, teachers, members of the police force, members of government contacting me, saying they agree with what I'm trying to do.
Anne-Marie, you have forgiven the drug dealer who sold your daughter that powder that that took her life. Do you think Martha would still be alive if these new laws that you're pushing for were in place?
I think possibly she might be. If she could have tested what she was about to take, she would have known it was 91%. She could have made an informed decision and she would probably have taken an awful lot less. Ultimately, drugs at the moment are driven by criminals. We need to take it out of the hands of criminals.
Which makes sense. How, though, have you been able, I suppose, to forgive that drug dealer who pretty much what he did sort of killed your daughter?
It was about healing for me. I didn't have any space for anger or bitterness. I needed to really look after myself and to recover from the shock of what happened. And early on, I felt peace and forgiveness and an incredible respect for my own life, because that's all I have left, really.
And I'm just curious, Anne-Marie, do you know what the drug dealer's position is on this? Does he think that ecstasy should be legalised?
I don't know. I might meet him in the next few weeks as part of the restorative justice measure that's in his sentence. I'd like to hear what he's got to say for himself and hopefully he can help me to heal a little bit from answering some of my questions.
We have really appreciated speaking to you today, Anne-Marie. Thank you very much for joining us. You also have written a book about your incredible experience, 5,742 Days, A Mother's Journey Through Loss. Thank you very much for joining us. And again, we are so sorry for your loss.
Thank you, Anne-Marie.